there's a word that will come on your screen. What is it called?
Secret.
Okay. Everybody know what secret is? Okay, so I'll ask you a few questions. Who like to hear secrets? Raise your hand. Okay. Is it a good habit? But we still try to hear secrets, okay? I'm very bad at that, you know? I'm very bad. There are times when a phone is kept, it's not locked, you know? I have a temptation to go and read messages, and at times when I find people's wallet, I like to. I don't do it. Okay, I've been bashed by Sasha for this. So, but I'll be very honest. I like to do that. You know, I like to hear secrets. I like to find secret. Okay, now it's up to you and God. Second question: who likes to keep a secret? Okay, that's very important. You know, if you know somebody's secret, you need to also know that you have to keep that secret, because that person has actually trusted you with that. Okay? And the third question is, who like to share secrets? You know what, where it leads to? When you start sharing secret, when that person is not? All right, gossip. So, see, our church is smart, you know. It's under a very good covering. Our pastor is a very good teacher, so church knows everything. And today we are not talking about gossip, okay? So, we all are expert in not getting into gossip. I believe so, right? All right. So, what does Bible say about secrets? You know, there are so many secrets in the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, and so many secrets have been explained and shared in the Bible. I'm just going to pick three major points from the secrets in the Bible. Okay, the first is, people have sinned in secret. You know, Bible is full of stories where people have sinned, they have done wrong against God, knowingly, sometimes unknowingly. One of the example is Ananias and Sapphira. You know, they thought that, you know, we can trick God, nobody would know. And you know what happened to them. Okay, it's in Acts chapter 4, so you can go and read about it. The second thing is, people have betrayed other people over secrets. Can you think of an example where when somebody shared a secret and that person betrayed that person? It's in Judges. One strong man. Samson and Delilah. You know, when he was born, God told his parents that you should never cut his hair and he'll be strong forever. He shared that secret with a woman and messed up. So, you know, she betrayed her over a secret. The other thing is, people have kept secret for their advantage. You know, like, there was a secret and it really held for the advantage. Any example you can think of? I've just picked three. There are plenty. I just picked three that is very prominent and very distinguished from each other. It's a woman in the Old Testament. It's Esther. You know, Esther and Mordecai, there she didn't reveal her identity to the king. Okay, we don't know the reason. There are many possible reasons that the theologians or scholars are trying to crack. But it really worked on her favor, because she kept her identity as a secret. You know, she was able to save the entire Jew. Amen. Now, there's a beautiful verse, you know. The reason I'm talking about the word secret, it's Psalm 139:7-12. Very famous scripture. It says, "Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence?" Have you ever tried doing that? I did. There was a moment in my life, things were not really working. Way back, not recent. Okay, way back. And you're like, "Oh, pastor, now." So, you know, I tried running away, but, you know, I failed. Okay, so know, this word is very dear to my heart. Like, where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? Next verse it says, if I go up to the heavens, you are there. Okay? Technically, heaven belongs to him. So he is definitely there. Then it says, if I make my bed in the depths, like in the deepest part of the ocean, okay, you are there. Okay? Next. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, you are there. If I settle far the side of the sea, even there your hand will guide me and your right hand will hold me fast. Amen. So God is everywhere. Okay. Now if you feel that you can keep secret from God, no chance. So stop trying doing that. Okay. The best thing that you can do to yourself is come in the presence of God and share all your secrets. Amen. Okay. Now this is what happens, you know, what happens in the secret place? You meet God in your secret place. Okay. You have encounters with God. Okay. Now when God gives you encounter, most of the time you will be in your secret place, in your lonely place. You get downloads from God. You know, you when God shows you things, you know, all the major prophets in the Old Testament, whatever they received from heaven, whatever the instructions they received from heaven, it happened in the secret place. Okay? And in the secret place, God will build you. Okay? It's in your secret place. Coming to church is good. It's very good. Okay? You learn, you know how to do things, you know what to do, you know how to fellowship, but what you do in secret matters the most. Okay, now people have actually mistaken this a lot, you know. There's a term which is called as lone Christian or alone Christian, okay, because there are few scriptures which emphasize a lot on you and God alone, okay. But if you see the Bible in totality, okay, Bible always emphasizes on fellowship. Okay, so you can have a good relationship with God, but at the same time, fellowship is more important. Okay, you need somebody to help you. You need somebody to guide you. You need when you fall down, you know, sometimes it's easy to pick yourself up, but at times you need somebody. Okay, and if you see throughout the Bible, God never sent anybody alone. Okay, God never sent anybody alone. For Moses, there was an Aaron. Okay, for every disciple that Jesus sent, he always sent it in two. Okay, every man and woman of God in the Bible, they had a helper. Okay, so don't mistake in the secret place so that you can have a lone walk with God. Okay, never do that. Let's read Psalm 91:1, very famous scripture. The most the favorite psalm that I have, you know. When I was small, when I was very small, one of my church elder, I shared with him, like, I have fear of darkness. Like, you know, when a room is dark, I get scared. He said, read Psalm 91, okay? And I read, I liked it. It was my chant. You know, every time I have to walk to certain place where it's dark, where there's no light, when power goes, electricity goes, I used to start chanting Psalm 91. And it says, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High will dwell in the shadow of Almighty. Okay, it's as simple and as raw. There's nothing more I can add to it. We all know, okay, we all are mature Christians. But let's today we're going to talk about the secret place. Okay, all the secret places that are mentioned in the Bible. Okay, it's just to help you, to encourage you, to identify you. Okay, your secret place. All right, now the first thing is, sometimes God asks you to build your secret place. Okay, you need, like, you know, it's a clear instructions from God to build your secret place. The example in the Bible is Noah. Okay, now you may think, no, Noah, it's a very small, you know, Noah is wrapped in one and a half chapter, It's you know, very short story. Where did he build his secret place? It's from Genesis 6 to 8. You know, God asked him to build an ark. Okay? And the ark was 450 feet in length and some 75 feet in width and approximately 75 feet in height. And who all were there in the ark with Noah? All the animals, okay? Now, and his family, his three sons, his three, their son's wife, and his own wife. And Noah roughly spent 5 months in that ark. Like, they were in the ark for 150 days, which is roughly around 5 months. Now tell me, if you are locked in a room with seven people for 5 months, what will happen to you? Okay, we just experienced that, you know, since 3 months. We technically experienced that, you know, we had all our emotions and frustration, if you can say that, you know. It was hard, honestly, it was hard, you know, locked up every morning, same face, you know. I love watching my wife's face, but I'm just telling you in general, you know, for 3 months. Now just imagine, Noah is in that ark for 5 months, okay? At least we don't have animals, okay? We have few of them have pets. There were animals in the boat, okay? Just imagine, so difficult, okay? And he also took provision for all the animals, okay? So all the animals were eating. And you know what happens when you eat, okay? See, you all are intelligent, okay? And he was there in that ship, okay? Nowhere else to go. At least we had a privilege of somehow sneaking out in the night, okay? Which we did. Everybody sneaked out and you know, just had a walk or something, but Noah didn't had. And I believe that's what happened, you know, 5 months in that ark with seven people, and he found a secret place somewhere in that boat, okay? And you know who built the first altar in the Bible? It's Noah. He realized that he got the revelation of building the first altar. It's in his secret place in that boat. Okay? For 5 months he was locked up. Okay? So there are times God will ask you to build your secret place. And whenever you get that instruction, please go ahead and do it. You know, you would definitely get some revelation. And that is the reason Noah was able to build the first ark. Okay? The second place is, you need to make your own secret place. God won't tell you. Okay? God won't tell you. Now, the example for this is Jacob. Okay? You know all the blunder that Jacob did. Okay? If you go and read Genesis 30, 31, 32, you will figure that out. Okay? And he's trying to come back to his hometown because he wants to fulfill God's promise, and he comes back, and you know, he unintentionally built his secret place. What happened is, if you go and read Genesis 32, verse 22 to 30, there Jacob wrestled with God. Now, before the wrestling happened, what he did is, he sent all his possession and his children away. To whom? To whom? Who was his brother? Esau. Okay, so he sent everybody out, okay, and what happened is, unintentionally, I believe, he was left all alone. Okay, and that's where God came, the angel of the God came, that's what it says, and they started wrestling. Now, there's too much interpretation and meaning of that wrestling, so I leave that out, but you know, he found somebody, okay, who was like God, who he mentioned in one of those verses, like, I saw God face to face. He built an altar there, and he called us place called Peniel, which means I've seen the God face to face. So sometimes you unintentionally build your secret place. Now, to identify that place is your job, okay? And you know, I was talking to somebody, and he mentioned that, you know, I will fight God, I will fight God. I said, no, you can't fight God. Nobody can fight God, okay? If you fight God, I can guarantee you'll lose, okay? If you fight with God, there is a guarantee that you will win, okay? Now here, Jacob wrestled with God. There's a big difference between the word fight and wrestle, okay? When you want to fight, you fight with weapon. But when you wrestle, there's no weapon. It's only your physical. So, you know, you can wrestle with God. Jacob did. But there's a consequence. You know what happened? His hip was wrenched. Okay? And it says, he only touched. He didn't even punch. Okay? He just touched and his hip was wrenched. So, be careful. Okay? Don't fight God. Nobody has ever been victorious in fighting God. Okay? If you feel that you're strong enough, wrestle with God. Okay? But beware, there will be a consequence. Okay? Now, the next is, God sometimes calls you to his secret place. Okay? Can you give me an example of from Old Testament? Moses, yes. You know what happened? You know, it's mentioned in Exodus 19:20, Exodus 34:2. Okay? Two times. What did God ask Moses? You come up to the mountain. Okay? And there he spoke with God face to face. Okay? And he was the only person who was allowed. Okay? So if your walk with God, if your trust in God, if your communion with God, if your relationship with God is like Moses, you know, there'll come a point in your life that God will call you up to his secret place. Okay? If it happened with Moses, can happen with us as well. If he did it before, he will do it today again. Okay. So you know, he spoke to God, he received instruction from God. Okay, and what better thing to receive instruction from God face to face? And Moses did. Now, after Moses figured out the secret place, he started something called as tent of meeting. How many of you know about tent of meeting? Okay, now, I'm not sure if God asked him to do, but it says Moses started having tent of meeting. It's in Exodus 33, chapter 33, verse 7 to 11. So what they used to do is, they used to camp a tent outside, like they put a tent outside the camp, and all the Israeli would stand there, and they would watch Moses walk towards the tent of meeting, and what used to happen? He used to disappear, and there he used to be inside the tent of meeting and receive instruction from God. Okay, now if you want to receive instruction from God, you have to build your own tent of meeting. Okay, and I love, you know, my spiritual father, Pastor Shaiju Matthew. He does a conference called Tent of Meeting. I am a product of Tent of Meeting. Pastor Priji, Elena, you know, so many people have been into that tent of meeting by Pastor Shaiju Matthew, inspired by Moses, and I'm telling you, it's such a blessing. So I can talk forever about tent of meeting, but you know, I want to encourage you all, you know, have your own tent of meeting, okay? You know, what we used to do when Revive Nations host a tent of meeting is, it's 2 or 3 days. We go to a very remote location. No phones, no internet, no laptop, no distractions, no connection with the outside world. Okay? And when I did my tent of meeting, when I came to Bangalore I landed, I spoke to my mother and my sister, like it was my first time traveling alone from Bangalore, so they were very concerned. I reached safely. Next morning, I wrote a small chitti, a letter to Elena, and I said, just message to this number. And I literally didn't talk to my sister, my mother, none of my family. I didn't speak with them. Honestly speaking, they never crossed my mind, because that tent of meeting was so beautiful. And I believe, you know, when you build your own tent of meeting, you will see God face to face. You will hear instructions for God, okay? God wants, God longs for you. Okay? Now, the other secret places, when sometimes someone else build a secret place for you. Okay, now somebody else build. The example is of, you know, that Shunammite woman and Elisha. What did she do? She was a very wealthy woman, okay? And she went and she told her husband that, you know, we see this prophet Elisha, he keeps coming, going and traveling. What she said, let's build a house for him. Let's build an upper room for him so that he can come there and rest. And Elisha used to go there and stay. Elisha used to go there and stay. Now, if you see the rest of the story, what happened? Okay, they lost the son. Okay, now just imagine if that Shunammite woman did not build that secret place for Elisha, and if she didn't build, and Elisha said, okay, there's no place for me to be in that place, he would have not visited there often. What would have happened? That son would not have resurrected. So you don't realize, sometimes you building a secret place for somebody else, okay, you inherit some blessing unknowingly. So now I leave up to you. That's my revelation, that, you know, you can build. Now I can't tell you how to build secret place for other people, okay? There are so many ways. Ask God to reveal you how I can build secret place for somebody else, okay? There's one very interesting secret place, okay? We all have been there, okay? Can you read? It says your womb was a secret place. Everybody came out of womb? Sure? No doubt? Okay. Okay. Now, when I was searching for the word secret place throughout the Bible, I landed up in this beautiful verse. It's from Psalm 51:6. It says, yet you desired faithfulness, even in my womb, you taught me wisdom in that secret place. So, you know, your birth on this earth, you living on this earth, is no coincidence, because God had you in his mind even before the creation of this earth. But even when you were in your mother's womb, he desired faithfulness, and he taught you wisdom in that secret place. So never take your life for granted, because you are precious. You know, God had you in mind when you were just a small, tiny cell, which even your bare eye can't see. You know, if you see how a childbirth happens, it's just a wonder of God. Okay, it's just a wonder of God. And God desires, he desired, okay? Now of course, nobody can go back into the womb, okay? But since you are outside the womb, you are on this earth, value your life. And make sure that you find your secret place. You be in your secret place. You learn to dwell in the secret place. And I'm telling you, it's not easy, because we are, you know, they say we are a social animal. Okay, so what do you mean by social animal? They like to socialize, okay? And thanks to all the social apps, even you now in your secret place, you have the social app with you. Okay, so learn to disconnect from things and be in the secret place. Okay, now I can't tell practically where is my secret place, because not everybody will like. Okay, if smart people would understand, but there are, you know, you need to find your secret place. Okay, so these are all the examples from the Old Testament. Okay, now it would be wrong if I don't speak about my Jesus Christ, okay? And there was a clear instructions about your secret place by Jesus Christ. Can you tell me where? Matthew, yes. It's in Matthew 6, 6. It says, but when you pray, go into your room, close the door and pray to your Father. Who is? Unseen. Then your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward you. Amen. Everybody wants the reward. I also want the reward. You know, I like to get rewards. Everybody wants to do the reward. But nobody wants to do the first three steps. That you have to pray. You have to go into your room. You have to close the door or shut the door or turn off the Wi-Fi or turn off your phone. Tell your best friend or your girlfriend or your boyfriend, please don't bother me. Okay? And when you go into that secret place, if Jesus is telling, it's in red letter in most of the Bible, He will reward you. Okay? So don't expect God to reward you without doing anything. Okay? Never do that. Okay? Now, there's something Jesus did beyond, like, you know, this is an instruction for you and I. You know, if you want to find your secret place, you have to do this 4 or 5 step. But Jesus often went to his secret place. You know, if you study the lifestyle of Jesus, what he used to do, okay? He used to preach sermon throughout the day, and in the night, what he used to do? He used to climb mountain, okay? You need to work hard to reach your secret place. You need to climb mountain, and trust me, climbing mountain is not easy. And Jesus did it. It's in Matthew 26, 36. It's in Luke 6, 12. And it also mentions in Luke 5, 15 that Jesus often went into wilderness. You know, he withdrew. He withdrew from the crowd. Whenever there was people coming, what he decided? No. I need to go meet my Father. I have to go into my wilderness. I have to go into my secret place where I can hear from God. Where God can hear me. Okay? If you're in a crowd and if you pray and you talk, okay? God is super powerful. Okay? He can. But you are not. If you pray in crowd, you will be distracted. And that is why Jesus said, like, you have to go to your secret place. You have to find your place where there is no distraction, where nobody can come between you and God. Okay? You know, it's a challenge, especially if you're married. You know, it's very hard. And when you have kids, oh, it's become a task. Pastor Kachi would agree with me, you know, Pastor Priji. You know, it's so difficult. Last night I was just sitting and preparing notes. Oh, it was so difficult when your daughters sit on the laptop and one is on your shoulder and they try, you know, when you're working on your laptop and somebody comes and press the power off button from your laptop. Oh, it's difficult. But, you know, you can't give excuse. I can't give excuse. You and I can't give excuse for not being in, like, you know, you can't say, I cannot build my secret place. You can't give excuse that I cannot find my secret place. You can't give excuse that it's difficult. Okay? It's difficult. You know, with man, it is impossible. But with God, and God is a God of wisdom. Okay? The Proverbs is there in the Bible. The book of Ecclesiastes is in the Bible. Okay? Read the Word of God. You would find ways, you would find people who have found a secret place. I just mentioned. Okay? So these are few examples. There are many, many other examples, you know. So these are the men and women of God, okay, who either obeyed God and reached their secret place, who built their own secret place, who built secret place for somebody else. Okay? Now here's the most interesting point. You know, there are times when your enemy makes a secret place for you. You know? Confused? Give me an example then. Give me an example from the Bible where your enemy made a secret place for somebody. John, yes. It's in Revelation 1:9. It says, I, John, was exiled from Ephesus by Romans into the island of Patmos. And you know what happened there. Okay? Now, he didn't want to go to Patmos. I'm sure he had no clue about being in Patmos Island. But what happened? The Roman soldiers exiled him. They forced him to be on that island of Patmos. And we all know what happened. What happened there? He had an encounter with God. And he wrote, I think, the best book in the Bible. It's the book of Revelation. Okay? It's been 2,000 years. People are still trying to decode it. People are still trying to find and understand. And you know, things that are written, most of it are already happening. Some of it we can see with our very own eye that things are happening now. And it also gives us hope. It also gives us promise of what's going to come. Okay. Now, just imagine if John would have, you know, I like when Pastor Shaiju in the Sunday service and Wednesday heart-to-heart conversation, he said, like, John refused to die, you know. They tried to kill him how many times? Three times? How many times they tried to kill John? Three times, four times, one time? No. They tried to kill him two times. And they put him in a hot boiling water, and he said, no, I refuse to die. Okay? And then they tried to kill him again. But even John didn't know that when my enemies will exile me, when my enemy would isolate me and put me into that island of Patmos, I would see God face to face. I would receive things from God. I would learn things from God. And I would write a book that for generations to come, people will remember what I wrote. Okay? So, you know, everybody has some or the other kind of enemy. My only aim and purpose here is to tell you the significance of being in a secret place. What are the secret place in the Bible? Okay? And you may not know, okay, you would have been in a secret place. Okay? So my question to you, I'm going to leave you with that. What is your secret place? Okay? Do you have a secret place of your own? No, it's okay if you don't have as of now, but it's not okay to not have a secret place. Okay? It's okay if you know that you had a phase in your life that you were going into your secret place, and now you no longer are dwelling in that secret place for whatever reason. Okay? But it's not okay to continue doing that, at least after this message. Okay? And if you need help in finding your secret place, it's not okay to struggle alone. Okay? It's not. You should never, your walk with God, okay? It's, you can keep it as personal as you want, okay? But don't shy from asking help. Okay? And that is why Jesus built the church on the rock, which is Jesus. Okay? Now, Jesus could have just found one disciple and he would have managed everything from one. Isn't it too hard for Jesus to do that? No, but he still chose 12. Okay? Jesus would have achieved more in a less number of time by sending 12 apostles at 12 different places. Okay? But he reduced his productivity of reaching to the Gentiles by 50% by sending two disciples together. Okay? So there is power in unity, there is power in submission, there is power when you ask help, when somebody helps you. Because, you know, it's not wise for you to reinvent the wheel, it's not wise for you to do things that somebody else has already done and you want to take that same path. No, All right. So that's my only encouragement to you. You know, you need to find your secret place. Okay. If you feel it's hard, ask help. But I can assure you, you know, you talk to any men and women of God, you talk to any pastors, you know, being in that secret place, you would fall in so much love with God that nothing of this world will take away that joy and peace that you have. Okay. Now, you know, we had this COVID situation. It's still going on. In fact, it has become worse in India. Okay. There was a stat, not to scare you, but a couple of days back, we had 20,000 cases in India alone. Yeah, that's what is happening. And now I think it's like a race against US and Brazil, like, you know, who will be on top three. It's technically look like that, you know, because now in between states also, there's a race happening. Tamil Nadu was 5, now it's 2. It's like, no, I will cross Maharashtra. You know, it's sad. It's sad what is happening because people are not abiding the law. People are just doing whatever. But we had this situation of COVID, okay? Now, I think for us, most of us, we were all struggling. You know, we had a routine. We were all it was like a robotic mode we all had, okay? But then this thing happened, everything stood. There was pause button hit by for whatever reason, you know. This COVID hit a pause button and we all had enough time. Okay, can anybody ever complain that they did not have time for past 3 months? Now, it's okay if you did not find your secret place or you did not spend enough time, okay? But it's not okay to continue to do that, okay? You just have to run to God. You just have to shut the door, you know? When Jesus said, when you pray, go shut the door, that door is not just literally physical door. There are so many doors that you have kept open, okay? You need to start identifying those doors, okay? It could be your job, it could be your relationship, it could be anything, okay? You need to find those doors, and unless and until you don't shut that door, it's very hard to have concentration, okay? You know, whenever you are on a call, if you find 5 people talking around you, is it easy to have a conversation on the call with the other people? No. So it's same thing with God. Same thing with God. Unless and until you shut the extra noise, you don't soundproof, you don't cut yourself, you don't draw boundaries, you don't cancel everything that is unwanted, it's very hard to concentrate. Okay, and that is why a secret place is very essential, because that will help you concentrate. You know, when you write exams, you know, I live examination halls. You know, when you used to write exam, there's a pin drop silence, and you know, then all of a sudden a pen will fall, a compass box will fall. You know, that it was fun. It was fun, and you know, it's a full planned noise making by the entire group. Okay, we with timings. Okay. If nobody's in school, so don't do that. Okay, don't. I hope my kids don't do it. So, you know, it's, you know, if you want to concentrate on something, okay, if you want to really concentrate on something, you have to shut things in your life. Now, if you don't, then don't keep crying and asking God, please, Father, please, God. You know, He is able. Okay, He is able. If you read Bible, throughout the Bible, it's mentioned that God is able. Does anybody over here doubt that God is not able? He is able, but there's always a condition. Unless there is complete surrender, unless you give away certain things, unless you reach a place where God says, my son, my daughter, now you're ready. All right. So that's my message. That's my message, you know, that you need to find your secret place. Get inspirations from Bible. Get inspirations from the people around you, from your pastors, from your leaders, from your spiritual father. Get inspiration and find your secret place. And I can guarantee you, ask any men and women of God, any, you know, yesterday Pastor T.D. Jakes and Stephen Furtick. So, you know, they were having a conversation, okay? Now, tell me, looking at their life, do you feel they did it without a secret place? Not possible, okay? Look at the life of Jesus. Forget about any human being. Look at the life of Jesus. Jesus is the real example in our life. Okay? If you study his life closely, okay? It's just wrapped in 4 chapters. Forget about all the 66 books. Okay? That 66 books revolves around those 4 chapters about the life of Jesus. But if you just keep reading, read the whole Bible, okay? Don't hold me against this. It's very important you read Bible from Genesis to Revelation. But take time and read about the life of Jesus. You will find certain secrets that Jesus did, okay? Which are no longer secret because it's revealed to you and me through the Word of God, okay? Read the life of Jesus and you'll realize that he often withdrew. He often find his secret place. The best place is he went to the mountain Gethsemane. You know, he prayed there. Now there also, okay, Jesus took how many apostles? 3. What are their names? Don't tell all the 12 names, okay? Only 3 names are there: Peter, James, and John. Okay, he took 3 people. He went to that mountain with his disciple, but he told them, "You stay here. I will go further because I want to talk to my God." Okay? You have to do that. Okay? And you know, when it's just recently that got revealed to me. When I was in Montreal with Pastor Shaiju, I was serving in Emmanuel Church. When Pastor Benny Hinn came to minister there, I was there for 3 weeks. And Pastor Shaiju, no? He had a habit of going. He said, I'm going to my mountain for a season. He took me once, and I think I've shared this story before. He went to that mountain, but he took 2 people with him, and we went there, and he said, "You stay here and you pray, I'll go and come." And he went and he was lost for 1.5 hours. Okay, it's now I realized he did what Jesus did. He took 2 people, he went there. He said the same thing, like pray that you not fall into temptation. He didn't say pray that you don't fall into temptation, though there were a lot of temptations around. But he said you pray, and he went and he prayed for 1.5 hours, and then he came back. That's a secret place. I don't know if he still goes to that mountain, but for a season, that mountain was a secret place. And you know how God has been using him mightily. And you know, that's my only desire, to serve God, to serve the body of Christ, to be like Jesus, and to be like my spiritual father. I've been praying, working hard, following, and you know, sometimes your desire become easy when you have good people around you. When you have people like Pastor Kachi, when you have people like Pastor Priji, when you have people like Pastor Jojo, when you have leaders around you, okay? So don't shy from this house, because you belong to this house and you know how you act in your own house, okay? You are not the most decent and well-behaved, you know? You are the most mischievous in your house, okay? Don't do mischief in church, but you know, we are there to help you. Please ask. Because somebody helped us. Okay? We have somebody from whom we learned how we went into that secret place. Okay? Now, there are times I just go on my terrace. You know, I just climb. And when I'm climbing that terrace step, I'm like, okay, I'm walking up the mountain. You know, it's just one floor, few steps. But yeah, that's my secret place. I go, I walk, I talk to God, and I make sure I go alone. Okay? So find your secret place. Amen. Was this word helpful? Would you start building your secret place? Will you ask help if you are not able to find your secret place? Okay. This church is not your secret place, okay? Okay, please. This church is where you come, you learn. But your secret place is what you do in your personal life. Okay? And you cannot give any excuse in your life if you're not able to build your secret place, if you're not able to have that relationship with God. You can't give excuse. Okay? You can't give excuse, I don't have time. You can't give excuse, I have too much work. You can't give excuse, I am married. Before it was easy, now I am married. I cannot. You can't give excuse if you have kids. You can't give excuse if you are not able to hold up your relationship. You can't give excuse if you are not able to take care of the resource, the wealth, the opportunity that God has given to you. You can't give excuse to God. Okay? You can give excuse to us. You can give excuse to us, and don't try to fool God. You know, one man of God said, like, you know, don't joke with God and don't fool God. We read Psalm 91:1. You know, if you dwell in the secret place of Most High, you will be under the hand of Almighty. And we read the Psalm. It says, you can't hide from God anywhere. So don't try. You'll just burn yourself. Okay, you'll waste your precious time. Okay, God is not at loss. Okay, God has done everything that He wanted on that cross. He sent His just Son Jesus, and He has already said, it is finished. Okay, how many of you believe that word? It is finished. Now it's your and my duty. It's your and my responsibility. Okay, and one last thing, you know, the gospel, don't keep it secret. I am standing here because somebody shared that secret with me. Don't keep the gospel secret. Okay? It's not only the duty of an evangelist to evangelize. We all are an evangelist. Okay? Don't keep the gospel as secret. Share with as many as you want, however you want. But share the real gospel. You need help? Ask us. Okay? And don't worry about the result. Okay? You know, evangelism is the only office where there's no result. You know, you just evangelize. You just share the word of God. Okay? It's the pastors who are more accountable. You know, they have to shepherd, they have to take care. You know, 7 times 70, if somebody goes away, comes back, the prodigal son, the lost coin, the lost sheep, you know, there are so many, you know. But evangelism is something that's the easiest office, but still it's the most difficult for us. You know, ask God, it's easy. You and I are sitting here, you know, in this beautiful setup, you know, too much light, I hope I'm shining. And it's because somebody gave the gospel to us. Somebody gave the secret of heaven to us, the kingdom of God to us. We can't take this life for granted. You don't need a pulpit, you don't need a mic, you don't need cameras, you don't need light, you don't need live stream, you don't need. If you can talk, you can be the voice of God. Okay? And that's my only prayer. Find your secret place where you would receive from God, and you can then share what God has put in your heart. I just did my part. Okay? Can we all close our eyes? Father God, thank you for this word. Thank you for speaking with us. And Father, help us to dwell in the secret place of Most High, because your shadow, when Almighty's God's shadow is over our life, we will fear no things. And thank you for being that good Father over our life. Yes, Master. You are good. You are good. Yes, Father, you are good. And continue to help in us. Continue to work in us and through us. We surrender our life. Have your way in our life. Help us to identify things that hold us up. Reveal things to us, Lord.